We have released new information and photos in connection with a near-fatal 2016 shooting in hopes of obtaining further assistance from the public. At approximately 8.05 a.m. on Monday, December the 19th, 2016, police were called to the 2200 block of 7th Street Southwest for reports of a shooting. Upon arrival, a man in his 40s was located injured inside a vehicle and was taken to hospital in serious condition. He later recovered physically from his injuries. Officers immediately flooded the area and began gathering information about suspect descriptions and the involvement of any vehicles. Shortly after, at approximately 8:10 a.m., a vehicle fire was reported a few blocks away from the shooting in the 3800 block of 7th Street Southwest. The investigation has revealed a white SUV was observed leaving the scene of the shooting at a high rate of speed. It is believed this same SUV was the vehicle that was deliberately set on fire shortly after the shooting. We have released photos of the vehicle, a white Hyundai Santa Fe, and are looking for information about the movements of the vehicle prior to 8 a.m. the day of the shooting. Since the shooting, this case has been actively investigated as an attempted murder. After pursuing numerous investigative leads and talking with a number of people, police have acquired new information about this crime and are once again seeking public assistance for information about the case. To protect the integrity of the investigation, we are unable to share the specifics of this new information at this time. Photos of the victim's windshield and credit card, both of which were struck by bullets, are being released. The titanium credit card was in the pocket of a suit vest being worn by the victim at the time of the shooting. These photos show how violent this encounter was. This attack occurred while people were leaving for work and children were leaving for school. The culprit's reckless disregard for public safety easily could have had fatal implications for not just the intended target, but also the people in the neighborhood. A tip line and email has been established in relation to this case. Anyone with information about this case or the movement of the SUV in the hours or days prior to the shooting is asked to contact police. You can contact police at 403-428-8400 or at a toll-free line 1-855-738-8400 or alternatively by email at mrs@calgarypolice.ca. MRS just stands for Mount Royal Shooting. Alternatively, members of the public who wish to remain anonymous can contact Crime Stoppers. I'll answer as many questions as I can, though please know this is an active investigation and I'm limited in the information I can publicly share at this time.
If this is one of the most affluent neighborhoods in Calgary, and we often hear from investigators that when you guys are doing an investigation in any neighborhood in Calgary, one in five homes has surveillance footage. I would assume the most affluent neighborhoods also do. Why has no footage of this alleged shooter in this jacket been... it seems just like so obvious. Like, why haven't we seen any footage of who we're looking for?
Yeah, what I can say is there's been hours of CCTV that's been combed through by our investigative team. At this time, what the police are willing to release are the photographs that are part of this release.
Can we just talk about the white SUV? I mean, again, just how that... What you can speak of how it went from at least lead into a suspect vehicle? Because at first it was this kind of, there was this burnout car, it was kind of unrelated. I remember shooting that scene. And then where, if what you can touch on to kind of led it to be a suspect vehicle?
Yeah, what I can confirm is that there has been evidence that has allowed us to establish and confirm that the white SUV that was burned at a nearby location was in fact involved in the shooting. I can say that we have confirmed who the registered owner was and that the vehicle was stolen at the time that it was used in the shooting.
And again, maybe just for a clip too, just again, the violence on this one again, like, as you said, you made a point of that this was a very violent shooting.
Yeah, as you can see by the photographs, the violence in this definitely a targeted attack. It's in a community where in daytime hours, through some of our conversations and with people involved in the community, we learned that children are in bed and they're hearing gunshots and they're jumping out of bed and going onto the ground because they're afraid. The police doesn't take that lightly, and it's important to us that we hold the offenders accountable in this case. I can't speak to that, or I just don't have the answer to that.
Are you able to talk a little bit about where the investigation is focusing at this point? We know a bit about the victim, fairly high profile real estate developer. Are police looking at business associates? Is that the general direction?
At this time, the motive has been unconfirmed. What I can tell you is that over a period of time and through investigative strategies, we know that allegiances between different individuals change, and throughout our investigation, we have developed new leads that allow us to move forward in pursuing those leads.
Are you asking for any more information from the public? There was a suspect that was a description that was released last year. Are you still looking for tips on that?
We're looking for any information the public has in relation to the vehicle on the days leading up to the shooting, the vehicle the morning of the shooting, and any other information that somebody feels would be relevant to help move this investigation forward.
So not any information on the suspect, whoever was described last year fleeing the scene?
We don't want to isolate any specifics about information that we want coming in. If somebody has information that they believe will help us to move this investigation forward, we would like to hear from them. I think as police, we never limit the options of where we look at for investigative leads. We'll follow where the evidence takes us.
What about, if you don't want to talk about who might be suspects in this, can you please confirm in a general way that this crime could be connected to the victim's business dealings?
There's nothing to confirm a motive at this time, and so I can't speculate on what that would be. Don't have the answer to that right now.
Is it believed that the people involved in this crime all live here? And
there's nothing to suggest location of the suspect's living arrangements.
So is there any coordination with other police forces or any other areas that the investigation is focused on outside of Calgary?
I can't answer that at this time.
The other pictures you're releasing, again, just the articles of clothing, can you go over that again?
So the photographs that were released are in relation to the vehicle that was confirmed used in the shooting, a white Hyundai Santa Fe, as well as pictures of the victim's credit card that was in a pocket of his vest at the time of the shooting. I don't have an answer to whether it's common. We have seen suspects in cases in the past that have used vehicles and then have burned the vehicle or lit the, obviously to attempt to get rid of evidence. So I wouldn't say common, but we've seen it before.
And sir, one last, just because I was shooting some B-roll, there was only gunshots on the victim's car, so there was no apparent gunshots on this car. Is that correct? When you said the statement, I couldn't tell if you said both cars had physical gunshot damage to them, like a return fire, or was it just the victim's car that had gunshot?
No, there was only gunshots in the victim's vehicle.
Okay, so I thought I heard something.
And
okay.
Do police remain involved in protecting the victim now that, you know, it's almost a year later? How involved are police in, you know, or is there any involvement in?
There's nothing specific in this case. I think in any case where we have had a shooting, there's always safety planning that goes into place with consideration with the entire investigation.
And how cooperative has the victim been with your investigation?
Very cooperative.
Okay.